Hello, friend. I have something for you. It's a devotional that begins with a scripture. These are the words from the Bible. Against all hope, Abraham in hope believed, Romans 4, verse 18. Abraham's faith seemed to be in complete agreement with the power and constant faithfulness of Jehovah. By looking at the outer circumstances in which he was placed, he had no reason to expect the fulfillment of God's promise. Yet he believed the word of the Lord and looked forward to the time when his descendants would be as numerous as the stars in the sky. Genesis 26:4. Dear soul, you have not been given just one promise like Abraham, but 1,000 promises. And you have been given the example of many faithful believers as a pattern for your life. Therefore, it is simply to your advantage to rely with confidence upon the word of God. And although he may delay in sending his help, and the evil you're experiencing may seem to become worse and worse, do not be weakened in your faith. Instead, be strong and rejoice, for God usually steps forward to save us when we least expect its fulfillment. His most glorious promises are fulfilled in a miraculous way. He generally waits to send us help until the time of our greatest need, so that his hand will be plainly seen in our deliverance. He chooses this method so we will not trust anything that we may see or believe as our ability to fulfill the promise, but trust that he did it. We are prone to do so, but we will take place our sole trust on his word, which we may always depend upon, no matter our circumstances. Remember, the very time for faith to work is when our sight begins to fail, and the greater the difficulties, the easier it is for faith to work. For as long as we can see certain natural solutions to our problems, we will not have faith or understand God's miraculous power. Faith never works as easily as when our natural prospects fail. George Mueller challenges us to put our faith in God. Today, put your faith in God, hoping faithfully for what God will do on your behalf.